hearing no gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Craft Farms here, and welcome back to another video here on Ravenport in FS19. Continuing where we left off on Friday, we got the spraying done and combined this field. So we are going to continue on with the harvest here, see how much more of that we can get done. I'm going to be kind of doing a mix of in-cab and out-of-cab. Because some people like the first person, some people like the third person view of the game better. So I'm going to kind of switch between the two, do a little bit of both. Just kind of switch between. Like I said, a lot of people like the third person, a lot of people like the first person, so going to kind of try and please everybody here. And I kind of like, it depends on what I'm doing, where I like third person better. Oops. And then sometimes I like first person. It really depends on what I'm doing. Combining is one of the things that I kind of like doing in first person a lot better. But some people like that better in third person as well, so we'll be kind of doing a mix of it here. We'll have to get our trailer here pretty soon. We're starting to get kind of full. The yield is definitely not as nice as I wish it was. That's kind of one thing that sucks about standard games. What the world? Apparently I wasn't back far enough. There we go. Now we got it. I like how the dust is kind of green colored. That's kind of odd to me. I guess I don't know. I don't think soybean dust is green. Pretty sure it's just kind of a, well, the standard dust color, really. I don't know how else to explain that one. Looks like normal dust. I definitely wish that you could use some of these buildings, like actually go inside of them. Kind of sucks that you can't. That's one thing too. Like I was talking about in the last episode, the map that I'm making. Like, it'd be nice to have working doors, because a lot of the buildings that I'm going to use are from FS17. And so, they all have the working doors and everything. So that's kind of one thing that kind of sucks. Man, that coffee's still hot. I've had this mug full of coffee for like the last hour and a half, 2 hours, something like that. Still as hot as it was when it first went in there. So we'll finish this field and then we'll go ahead and dump the combine. I'm hoping for 3 or 4 combine. Full combines be a pretty decent amount, I think, but we'll go ahead and we'll back up a little bit and we'll go ahead and stick that out. Is that supposed to be a light? It is. Nice. Okay. So I'm trying to play as realistic as possible and not use tab at all. If I'm in a hurry, I might use it, but I kind of want to play as realistic as possible and not use it. It'd be nice if they added IC controls standard. That'd be kind of neat. I do like how a lot of things have dynamic hoses on it too, standard. That is very nice. I'm glad that they actually put that standard. Other than you having to try and learn it. I mean, obviously you'll still have to learn how to add it to mods and everything, but can't really see the auger. There we go. Perfect. Let's go ahead and fill the front of the trailer first. Another thing they added to this game that I really, really like is if you use, like, the Load King or the Wilson, because they have separate hoppers, you can actually haul two different crops, which I think is really, really nice. You know, if you're using, like, the Seed Hawk or something, you could have the front tank full of seed and then the rear tank full of fertilizer, and then you can load it, you know, like that, which is definitely very nice. I like that they added that feature in there. I know they updated some of the lighting and like textures and stuff as well. Some things look really nice. That sprayer. One thing about that sprayer is it was like later at night and I was spraying, or maybe it was early in the morning, and it just had like this big white glare coming off of it, which was kind of annoying. But at the same time, you know, it's like a chromey kind of look on the booms. And so, I mean, technically in real life it was kind of chrome, then you'd get the sun bouncing off of that as well, I think, but I don't know, it's nice, but it's not. I mean, they definitely tried something different there, but it definitely doesn't take long to combine these fields. I think one thing that I would like to do is get a plow and combine these two fields. And I wouldn't combine that one because of the road, but maybe kind of nice to combine these two fields at least. Make it a little bit bigger here. So I'm guessing this combine must hold like 10,000. Yeah. Oh yeah, we gotta put death in this thing too, that's right. So I have yet to kind of figure out how that works, how the whole death fluid thing works. I guess that's got its own separate kind of reading, or, cause I mean, if you look here, it only shows the fuel level. It doesn't show a separate thing for def. So I don't know if it, like, how it works. I haven't really played enough of the game to really find out. I think I've only got, like, maybe 4 or 5 hours logged on the game so far, since it came out a little over a week ago. So about, it'll be just about 4,000 liters off of this field. A little less than half a combine, so that's not actually too bad. I mean, I guess if you think about it, combine those two fields and it had just about a full tank. So on these three fields, it's a little under half a tank, half a grain tank per field. Alright, there's another one done. So we got one more left down here, and then we'll have to load up the header and move fields. Oops, I think I'll start on this end. What the world? Oh, I hit V, not B. Helps to turn the combine on. Helps a lot. Yeah, the combine is definitely very nice. I like this combine. For being a European combine, it's not really all that bad. I've never seen a T series combine here in the US. I mean, I guess there could be some somewhere. I just personally have never seen one. I've seen the STS combines and the S series combines for John Deere. That's all I've ever seen. I want to avoid hitting this tree. The one nice thing about running smaller headers is it's easier to see your edges. Whereas, like, if I was running a big header, you know, like the big, see, what is it, the 645 flex draper, that one would be a little tougher to see with. That's another thing that I really dislike about this game is that you hit escape, the combine keeps running, or anything that you're in keeps running. I don't really like that, but yes, it is what it is. Wow, two passes and we got 4,000 liters pretty much. So this field's running a little better than the other ones did. Which is not bad. So we'll get down to the other end, we'll turn around, then we'll have to get the tractor again. We'll have to unload once we get turned around here. If we can even make it to the end anyways. I don't think we're going to. Nope. 9,800. 9,900. Come on. Oh, you gotta be kidding. One little strip. Man. Okay. We'll run over to the tractor here. Kinda curious to know what this building would be for. It's got the little silo. I wonder if it wouldn't be like a chicken coop or something. Which I wonder. Animal pens. So you got doghouse. Okay, so this is what the chicken coop looks like. So you guys let me know. Do you think we should get the doghouse? What do you guys think? Okay, so there's a pressure washer. I have a couple different fuel. So we got this fuel station and then this one. And we got, this is lime. This is another liquid fertilizer. This is herbicide. So I don't have weeds on right now. But we'll have to get this and maybe turn them on. Oops, wrong button. So you got your different silos. I downloaded this one. This is the silo off of Lone Oak Farm that somebody made placeable. A sandcastle. A farm garage. So, I mean, it'd be nice to use some of these. Farm storage, okay. Just a decorative object. And you got farm trailer, old barn. I mean, it'd be nice to use some of these things, but I do have this. It has working doors. So I wonder, we might have to look into like selling one of these old buildings and putting that down or something. You got a couple storage sheds. You got the farmhouse. Yeah, it'd definitely be nice, you know, like this, like the pickup and the Mahindra could go in there. It'd be nice to be able to use some of these objects rather than just be decorations. Because, I mean, unless it's old and run down, you don't really have a building for decoration on a farm. You use all the buildings. Alright, let's run over here to the combine. And go ahead and unload it. So we're going to try and get the front of the trailer filled up the rest of the way. Or maybe we'll start filling on the back. I don't know. We'll kind of, yeah, we might just kind of even it out a little bit. Oh, no, we'll fill the front and then we'll fill the back. And then fill the center. Same way I fill hopper trailers. Jump to the back of the trailer here and start filling that up. Yeah, with hopper trailers, I usually fill the front, and then I fill the back, and then I fill the center. But with the way that they have them set up now on the hopper trailers here in 19, it doesn't quite work that way. I mean, I guess you can, but it doesn't quite work the same that it did in 17 there. Pick up this little piece here. Good, we're gonna miss that tree again. The graphics here in 19 definitely aren't bad. I kind of like the way that they are. The one thing about doing maps in 19, though, that I don't like is that it's got the sun. So when you go to take a PDA picture, you can see the lines. I mean, it's not hard to, like, turn off or, like, make it so it's invisible or something, but, or make it so it doesn't show the light lines, but that and fog. Like, when you zoom out to take a PDA picture, it looks all foggy. It's kind of weird. I don't know why they have it like that. I mean, like, if you look at the PDA here, like, you don't notice it's foggy. But obviously, Giants, they would have done it their own way to make a PDA picture. It made it a little bit different. So, we got one more pass. We are taking a full header right now. Very full header. I do like the feature where these things show wear. I mean, our tractor is the thing that has the most wear on it right now. But it's not showing yet. But that's definitely a cool feature, I think. That kind of like the paint chips and stuff like that. Raiders used Cooper wrong. What? It's got a notification from the NFL app. Something about somebody using somebody wrong or something like that. I don't freaking know. All I do with football anymore is check the scores after the game's over. That's about it. I don't really watch the games anymore. Packers and Cowboys are my two teams, so I just find out when they're playing, and then I'll check the score. Sometimes I'll check the score while the game's going. Other times I'll just wait until like the next day and look at them and see who won. That's about it. So when we're moving these things up to those other fields, I will use tab because I'm not going to walk all the way up there, all the way back, because that's quite a distance. If I had the player speed camera mod, I would definitely do it because I can run a lot faster with that mod. But unfortunately, that is not out for 19 yet. Okay. Oops. I do have it set, so I have to start the engine. Sometimes I forget about that. I wish, like, once you started the engine, it would stay running until you shut it off, rather than it turning off like it does. That would be kind of nice, but unfortunately they did not do that. I do like, though, the grass and everything, how it moves as you run it over. That I find very, very nice. I really like that feature. Okay, let's actually just put this in the field where it's a little more level. There we go. Even this thing, the drawbar is pretty much on the ground. Or not the drawbar, but the tongue is pretty much on the ground. They should have moved the ball down a little ways. But I suppose they figured you use a tractor to pull the header trailer. I don't know why they would figure that. I mean, you would use a pickup for that. I like, too, how the headers seem to lock down a little better than they did in 17 and 15 and all the other games. Like, if you would put a header on a header trailer, you'd turn and it would just go flying. And that was kind of annoying. And the whole seat moving is kind of weird, too. Like, it turns side to side as you turn. Like, it leans. I don't know, that's just kind of weird. I mean, I guess you would kind of lean a little bit when you're turning, but not quite as much as this leans. It'd be nice if your interior camera kind of moved up and down with the seat, though. Then you're not just seeing the seat bounce up and down and you're just sitting there. But then again, it would probably make some people sick to have it going up and down, up and down. But for me, I wish it would do that. Because it is rather annoying to watch the seat going up and down while you're just sitting stationary. I mean, unless you can hold your head in one spot just like that. But I am pretty sure there is nobody that can. I did try cotton harvesting as well in my live stream, and it's not bad. The one thing I do want to try is this trailer for cotton. You back up to the bale and it loads it. And I'm wondering if there's a way to make it so it actually does like round bales as well. Because that would be kind of neat to do. I don't know how many of you guys remember, in FS15 I had made a stack mover, and that was my first ever mod, so it wasn't, I mean, it it's not great at all, model wise. But it'd be kind of cool to make a new one and have it scripted the same way as that cotton bale trailer and use it for round bales. That would be pretty sweet. I think that'd be kind of nice to have. My family hasn't used stack movers for as long as I can remember. My great grandpa did use it, but he just loaded it with a tractor because they ended up replacing chains a lot because they would dig into the ground and then they'd break, or, you know, stuff like that, or maybe it'd blow a bearing out or something like that. That's what my dad always told me anyways, that, you know, they used the stack mover trailer, but they would just load it and unload it with the tractor, rather than, you know, actually using the chains. But so they haven't, I haven't seen them used. I mean, like the way that they're supposed to be used, for a really long time. I mean, I was very little when they were doing them like that, so I don't really remember that, but I've seen videos of them. I've seen other people using them, or heard of other people using them. And so, come on, the brakes suck on this thing. But it would definitely be cool to have, if it would actually work for round bales. So we got basically a full bin worth out of that other field. Which is not too bad, actually. We're going to pull this down by this other field here. Just kind of off to the side. Right by the bushes. Oops, I need this. So this trailer's getting pretty close to full, which is a good sign. We'll see how much we can get. I'm hoping to fill this trailer and then have maybe at least a quarter of a trailer, because I don't want to fill this trailer and then have like another couple thousand liters and then add that to the 4,000 that's already in there and only go and haul like, you know, under 10,000 liters. I'd like to get another 10,000 liters on another trailer is what I would like, but obviously it's probably not going to work that way. Okay, I'm going to miss that. I think all we'll do is we'll just unload the combine right now before we get into the next field, and we'll just start fresh on that field. I have a feeling I'm only going to get another full hopper. That's about it. That's kind of my guess. Definitely some weight on this trailer, you can tell. Cab of the tractor is about even with the top of this trailer. Guessing we're getting pretty close to done with this episode. We're gonna go ahead and put the tractor right about here, and we'll just back the combine up to it. Try not to drive over that guy's canola too much. Yep, go back a little bit more. There we go. I'll start filling the center of the trailer here. Yep. There's our timer. So, what we'll do is, okay, so let's see how full this trailer is here. First. So we're at 25,003 and it holds 31. Oops. So we got room for another like 6,000 liters in here. It's another, about a little over another half full combine. So go ahead and shut that off. There's death right there. So what we'll do is in the next episode we will finish combining. And then we'll see what happens there. I'm not sure when the next episode will be. Maybe I'll try and have like Friday, Saturday, Sunday be my upload days. We'll kind of see how it plays out. But that's going to do it for today. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Make sure to hit that subscribe button if you like what you see. And make sure that if you haven't already, that you hit that little bell. And it'll notify you every time I upload a new video. And make sure to leave your thoughts down below. I usually try to respond to every comment. Deborah Joseph. Interesting name. But yeah, guys, that is going to do it for me today. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you guys in the next video.